Pete Hickerson here for RC Sport Flyer Magazine. Well, here we are in Las Vegas, Nevada at the National Association of Broadcasters Convention. We came here to look for helicopters, a little bit smaller than this one. We're here at the DJI booth, NAB, and we're talking to Willis Chung.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about the new things that you have from DJI.
At DJI, we first and foremost, let's talk about this thing very quick.
Okay.
This is the new DJI Ronin, and what this is a handheld gimbal, much like the gimbals that we hang on the bottom of our Phantoms, our S800s, S1000s, but it can take 16 pounds of weight capacity. So a Red Epic, a Red Dragon, with your Preston or C-Motion or any of those things, accessories, no problem. Now another product we have is the new Phantom 2 Vision Plus, which you see flying right there right now.
Yeah, Michael just flew that for us.
Oh, he did? Great. So he talked to you about it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Perfect. So this is the new model?
Yes, sir. This is the Phantom 2 Vision Plus. It comes with a camera and a 3-axis gimbal. So it gets really smooth, beautiful video while it's up in the air.
Now this is a new product. It's a different camera, isn't it?
Well, it's actually a lot of the same features as our previous camera. It's got 14 megapixel pictures, 1080p video. One of the cool things that we've upgraded with this is the Wi-Fi range extender. While it's up in the air, you can still get Wi-Fi connection even at 700 meters away.
Wow.
Yeah. So you know, you can get that first-person view flying.
And with that, how long does it run?
25 minutes.
25 minutes.
Oh, 25 minutes of flight time with a smart battery that's really easy to pop in and pop out.
Nice.
Yeah.
What's different about this than the Phantom 2?
So the Phantom 2 actually uses a lot of the same build as this one. The main difference is the smart integration of the camera into the platform. Okay. So with the camera that's already mounted, it's already wired for first-person view flying. So you just open it out of the box, download the app, and pretty soon you'll be able to see what the camera is seeing on your smartphone in real time.
Okay. What's the benefit of that gimbal?
The gimbal provides really great video. We had a previous system, the Phantom 2 Vision, and photographers loved it. You could get up in the air and take great still photos. The problem was is that on two axes, on both yaw and roll, you'd still get a little bit of shake, particularly whenever you're flying fast or you get any wind. So people that were using this for video, we're looking at our H3 3D gimbal and saying, well, can we just combine these two? Can we get the same video while at the same time getting the out-of-the-box experience that the Vision offers? And that's what the Vision Plus does, is it combines the best of both worlds for our Phantom users.
So when you get a bump by the wind, this will compensate?
Well, watch for yourself. See, I'm not a great pilot, but at the same time, you can see the camera stays amazingly steady.
It looks to me like you don't have to be a great pilot.
Well, I'm learning. I still want to get better.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
But you know, that's going to be great for video.
Yeah.
You know, usually you want establishing shots and fly around the building or coming up from the floor like a jib shot.
Well, you know, the cool thing is, because it's so easy to use, everybody is able to take it out of the box and create some unique application for it. So we're already seeing firefighters, archaeologists, search and rescue teams that aren't RC specialists, that are already able to put this into use for their day-to-day work. It's fantastic.
To get the benefit of it, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
That is great. That looks like a nice package, all in one.
Yes, sir.
Well, thanks for talking to us.
I'm Michael.
Michael?
Yeah. Anytime, Pete.
Great awesome. Little product.
Pretty amazing. Three axis gimbal, 1080p,
yeah.
14 megapixels, yeah. 2,000 feet of range.
Yeah.
Awesome.
What's the frame rate on that, on 1080?
For the Vision Plus, yeah. It's up to 30 frames per second. It already has 25, and just, yeah.
So okay.
30 frames per second, 720p, you could go up to 60 frames per second okay. for slow motion.
What about if I have like a 5D Mark III? Do you have anything for that?
We do. We have the S1000, which is an octocopter.
Nice. Can we go look at that?
Absolutely. Yeah. So I'm just going to power this up. And this here, you're going to see a very familiar camera. Canon 5D Mark III. And yeah, you're able to get your stable images from this copter.
Okay, now this has how many blades?
It has 8 blades, and it's very modifiable. Oh, you want me to pick it up? Oh, yeah, we want to see like the adjustment from the Z15 Zen Muse. So it's super stable. So if you have high winds, this thing's going to fight the wind very well while keeping your image very stable.
Nice. Yeah. Now, what is the payload capacity? How many pounds?
I don't have an exact number for you, but I also do not recommend you putting anything more than a 5D right now. Right now.
Okay.
Meaning...
The Blackmagic...
That's
that
no problem.
One?
The pocket cinema
camera?
In fact,
I see one there. Yeah.
There you go. How'd you guys get this? I don't even have one. That's awesome.
Awesome.
Nice. So, pocket cinema camera.
Sure.
Awesome camera. Yeah, this is the hexacopter, 6 blades.
What's the total flight time on that with a 5D?
With a 5D, it depends on the battery. They're modifiable. You could put big batteries on there, and you could get up to like 15 minutes. But on a normal, more common workflow, people are putting 2 5,000 milliamp batteries on there, and you're getting average of like 8 to 10 minutes.
Okay, but that's a major lifter.
Yes.
Okay. So a monster copter.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay.
That's cool. What you can do with this, I mean, people keep saying that you can do all these aerial helicopter shots, but what I'm kind of like trying to tell people, let them know, is that there are things that these copters can do that a helicopter cannot. Example, like there's these paddle boarders or something like that, or surfers. You can get down close to them on the water, and you won't disrupt the water. You know, there's no way you can bring a helicopter that close.
Right.
That's just one example. There's plenty of other ones. Get really close to talents.
I see the armatures fold in. How about the landing gear?
The landing gear folds up when you take flight. You have the ability to flick a switch on your radio transmitter, and then, and it just folds up. So you can actually spin. Here, can I disconnect it for a sec? So with the Zen Muse gimbal, it comes with a slip ring right here, which enables you to spin 360 degrees unlimited times. It just keeps on going.
Nice.
Yeah.
So if you want to make your audience sick.
Well, you can do that. But it's more about you don't want the cables being tangled.
Right.
So
exactly.
It goes through the system over here and through the slip ring.
All right. Nice. So you can pan with the controller on
yes.
the ground.
Yes.
And how about getting the picture back to the operator?
There are a few different ones that we have right now. The first one is the 5.6 gigahertz standard definition transmitter, and you can go pretty far with it. And the other one we have is the new light bridge. So that enables you to go almost 2 miles without any hiccup on video signal, 1080p signal.
What is the frequency?
It's 2.4.
Okay.
So your radio transmitter is also 2.4, but the good thing is you disable that radio transmitter and you work off that one light bridge system. So that receiver
so
actually hooks onto
that.
The... Exactly.
I see.
Exactly.
Nice. so there's no conflict.
Exactly.
Cool.
Exactly.
That's a great product.
Yeah. We've got a lot of things on the horizon.
Anything else
there.
New?
Let me think. What did I tell you? We talked about this, the new Phantom 2 Vision Plus. There is something that people have been talking about a lot, is the ground station. Are you familiar with that?
No.
Essentially, it is motion control. So there's two ways. There's the PC version, and then there's the iPad version. You wouldn't need a controller anymore. I mean, it'd be good to always have to manually override. But I can program this device or the Phantom devices. Fly up. You need GPS for this. But fly up, go in a circle, just tell it where to go. Just point a few different spots on an iPad, and it's going to fly those spots.
So it's kind of like waypoints on the GPS.
Exactly. That's exactly what it is, yeah.
And can you tell it how high to be at that
yes.
waypoint?
Yes.
Nice.
Yeah. It's pretty incredible.
Yeah. Pretty amazing stuff.
Yeah. And with the PC version, you can get really precise coordinates.
Nice.
To where to go.
Well, thanks for talking to us.
Of course. Yeah, sorry you had to wait. Like.
No problem. Have a good day.
Yeah. Thank you very much, man.
Yeah.
Thank you.